Okay, this semester, we're going to learn Impressionist artist work. Okay, then Impressionist artist work is all about color and light. So, this is Monet's artwork. I think everybody knows Monet, right? He painted lots of his Lily Pond and very, very famous Impressionist artist. So for him, he, as you can see, he never used black. See, it's even the darkest part, he doesn't use black. He thinks the, in real life, there isn't black because all the lights and won't have a pure black in the color. So he doesn't use black, but it doesn't mean like other artists cannot use black. So they can use black, but his style, he doesn't use black, but he makes color make it very dark. What I want you to see this three picture by him is he has several like series of pictures. He just painted one spot, but in different time of the day. Like, I think that probably be a sunset. That's almost sunset. Maybe that's morning, right? It's like different time of the day. So different time is exactly the same spot. But a different time of the day, the color looks different. I think the reason he pick, with water, because water reflect the light from the sky. So if, that's what the Chinese call the shui tian yi se, like the water and the sky is one color. Because the water reflect color from the sky, right? The reflect color from the sky. So I think that's why he picked like water. But he has a different pictures without water, without picking water. But still, the color is different at each picture through different time of the day. And the class, I really want you to experience the color, and don't afraid of using color. Don't afraid to emphasize color. Like, this cannot be that blue, but he emphasized the blue color. So it looks very blue. I wanted to show you another picture I really like. It's not Monet. This is a modern artist and recent artist. I really like his work because first of all, I like how he uses brushes, right? The brass stroke is very like strong, I like that. And also what I like is how he used the color on the face, the green, the blue, and purple. So like you think about how the people have that much of color on the face, because we don't, right? Look at me, like if I put my hand there, but he emphasized it. Like if I put my hand there, here, you can totally see there's lots of blue in there from the sky, right? And that's warm color, right? So that's reflect color from the sky. But I think he emphasized it. He made it more, obvious what that color is. So I really like it. So go back to our Monet picture. So I really want you to emphasize the color, but at the same time, go back to the value. I mean, you don't want to make those too dark and you can't see the shape of this, right? So that has a contrast. And this have less contrast. See, it's almost the same. So yeah, just be careful about that. And we're going to practice some Manet's drawing, and I want you to learn color experience, because impressionist is a very, very important part in art history. It's probably the most important part in art history. So there's lots of famous artists there, like Van Gogh, I think everybody know, but he's a post-impressionist, like a little bit later. So he even, use more bold color for his work. Okay, enough talking. So as you see, I picked this dark blue one, and you have different colors. I like a dark color because it can give a rich tone under. And if you have a dark brown, you can use dark brown, and you just need to put more blue in there. But I just like to use a more darker kind of picture, paper. So I'm going to move this. Want you to see how I grab those colors. So that's how important and how I use those colors. And let's see, you want to have a tape everything because sometimes I'm missing. That'll be bad. Okay, let's see. I'm going to do this one first. Oh, yeah, that one first. Okay, so if you can, just, so many colors. And like I said, when you're using like paints, right, paints, you have to mix all those color on your palette. You grab a little green, you grab a little yellow, you mix, then you put on here, right? You put on your canvas. But with pastel, basically, you're mixing color on the paper, right? You are mixing color on the paper. So you put up those color together, then you like wrap it or you do something. Then we're mixing it. So just, because you're going to mix all the color together, you want to just, in the beginning, just layer it, okay? And for this oil pastel, for this, because the paper is like very rough, so sometimes you have to kind of push it a little bit. And push it, right? Bumpy too much, sorry. Then you can see the from little blue, then getting like lighter and lighter, no, yellower and yellower on the bottom, warmer and warmer color. It's kind of cold color, then gradually go to more warm color. So yeah, so just don't afraid of draw, okay? That's the most important thing. Like I told you guys all the time, be like brave to put there, like having fun with it. Don't afraid to draw. It's most important thing is, don't afraid to draw. So I'm going to mix way more color in there, but right now I'm just need a base, just get rid of the dots on the paper first. So probably need a more
warm yellow in there. And you can always use your finger to smudge if you want.
Cause the background color, blue color, so it comes out. Mine is too cold, so I need some warm color in there.
Cause it is a sunset. It's more like warm color. I'm going to get kind of like this beige color for the lighter color. Yeah, that's better. See, it's more warm. I want to get the warm sunset tone in there, right? And you don't need to color like exactly, but you need to have that feeling of the sunset color. That's most important, right? It's just for you to learn all the different colors. So when you go out, you see the sky or you see the sunset, you have a different feeling of it. You can see more color in there, like Monet, right? Leave that triangle and pointed thing there. The shape, it doesn't really matter that much. This is a little warm salmon color, actually. This part is more yellowish. Remember, this is our first layer, right?
So the reason you look at Monet's picture is like,
it doesn't have much detail, right? Because he's a capture the moment, like the moment of the color. You know like how fast the daylight just gone, right? The like sunset, it's just like probably it's just half hour, right? And it's gonna get dark. So this is a plein air drawing, means he go to that place. It's not from a photograph, okay? So he go to this place and he sit there, and then he wait, you know, the sunset goes down, then just in like a half hour or so, he has to capture the instant of the sunset, right? So he doing very fast. That's why there's not much detail, but lots of color. So that's what he wants to paint, just the color, right? This color is just mainly for a base color. Then you kind of, you know, mixing color on top. So can you see this? So he's using oil painting. I'm using pastel, but you know, it's the same thing. It's just that when you're drawing, no matter you use a pastel, you use a color pencil, or you use acrylic, or you use oil painting, when you're drawing, you basically the thinking is the same. And where you look, how you're doing, you're thinking the same. The only difference is the technique from the different material, right? Different material have different technique. So like watercolor, watercolor technique, oil painting, as oil painting technique, and you know, that's the difference. But technique you can learn, that's easy to learn, but if you know how to do use a color pencil to color, you're definitely going to learn very fast with oil painting, because it basically is the same. Your thinking is the same. It just the way you do it is different. That's easy to learn, but the thinking is most important, right? So you know how to do it is the most important. If you don't know how to do it, then, you know, what you look, what you're thinking, which color you're going to use, which color mix, which color, then that's all the same, right? The only difference is the technique is different. So I'm going to use this too for the bottom. That's a base color. Okay, for that, need more color. And now there's a bunch of blue color here. Purple, some purple here too. It's a little darker purple. I'm just looking for those shape of the blue, but I'm not like copy it totally, like literally copy it, just kind of, because the shape is not that important than the color. Mainly, I just want you to play with the color.
It's a little dark. This part is light. Make this a little bit skinnier.
Looks a little fat. This is too long.
So see, it's very easy to
fix the shape. Cause there's not much shape there. Kind of like base color, and you add more color in there later. From here, so this salmon color is not exactly that color, but just want to make a base color, because you want mixing color, okay? You don't want to just, you know, put one color in there. So you want to mix the color. So this color is more, the salmon color is more neutral color, right? It's not too bright. That's why I'm using this, because you can put a bright color on top. So, you know, you can't totally cover this. But if you put a very bright color, then it's very hard to put other color on top to cover it. So that's why I'm using this muted salmon color, because it's not that bright. Need to work on that part. This is more like turquoise color. That part is more like that. That part too. Okay. Let me see. I guess some. You have a more light purple. See my light purple. That's a light purple, kind of too light. Okay, because I want to fix this part a little bit. It's kind of too light. Remember, I have a light purple somewhere. Oh well. Let me work on this building more. So see how many color on my hand? Don't put it in, okay? It takes too much time. Then you get tired of picking it up. You just use one color, finish everything. Is it like on the edges always kind of like little blue color in there? Shape is off, not very clear, right? It's very faded shapes, especially in the end. Now you have that. You want to it's too, the color too simple. There's some color in there. Then you can add some red. Make it darker, and there is some warm color in there. Yeah, I can add some yellow in there. Yeah, just mixing color and ultramarine blue. It's more like the color of the paper, actually. So when you want to get a darker, is darker red plus darker green or darker blue, it get very dark, right? That's what he used for his work. okay? Just essence of the color, okay? Well, the shape is not very important. They do get some warm color in there, so it's very important because the sky is, you know, reflect the warm color on them. I like this picture, very colorful. Okay, I guess I made that too white. Uh-oh, that's okay. I'm going to put this up a little bit. Okay, water gets more. Work on that. Don't drop. Oh, I just put color in there. Some pink in there. This is a little bit lighter than this side. Oops. This side is more purple than that. That's more green than this, right? Can you tell? It's more like purple.
And that. So that's more green.
It's more light than the right side. So do this, don't make it too smooth, so you leave that some of the spot for different color, okay? Kind of like that. Trying to find a color is this color seems hard to cover the blue, but I will try. Let me see if another color about that color. Yep, that's better. That's better. Kind of just, you know, make this and leave some that, and later on you can fill out the dark part with some other color. But in the beginning, just try fill the color, but not too flat, make it more like a wave. This part is way more red than that, but it's okay. You can put the red on top of that orange. So now just, you know, still making the wave. Because my paper is too dark, so I need a kind of like the light base so I can put bright color on, otherwise won't go.
So
now I can add one more layer of the water. And this one is lighter than the one before. So this,
you can see this side, the contrast is less. That means the blue and the yellow, if you squeeze your eyes, look, you don't see that much dots like that one, right? It's more contrast. So I need to work on that, make less contrast.
Means I need to make those blue lighter. I can make those like this. See now. Okay, less dots.
Work on them more. Some part need to pop up. And the yellow is not work as well. I think that's a good yellow. Pops up more.
Right now you have to be careful like where you put it. Okay, now you use make a little shiny spot. This side is more pink.
fixing. Now I squeeze my eyes to look at it and see what needed to fix. Squeeze your eyes. I bet this part is still too dark. Some purple here.
And make some light sparkle with water. So think about it.
This one. Okay, that's about it. Hope you have fun with it.